Hi everyone, welcome back to Faith and Flower. If you're new here, my name is Robin, and in today's video, I'm going to walk you through my Bible study routine. It's really very simple, but this is something that has been requested, and I know, speaking for myself, it can be really encouraging and inspiring to see how others do their Bible study or their quiet time each day. So I'm really excited to share that with you. If you have been watching my channel for long, you may know that I really love using the Bible recap. I'm going to give you a lot of details about that, but most of it will be down in the description box so that you can access everything that I do. It's all free. And so basically what the Bible recap is a reading plan that will help you read through the Bible in just 1 year from beginning to end, but it's using a chronological format. And all that means is that the Bible is arranged in the order of the events as they occurred. So the Bible traditionally isn't put together that way. It jumps around a little bit. So I love this format because for me, it really helped me see the big picture of the Bible. And so I'm just going to show you what I do each day and give you a little bit of background into my thinking on why this is a great method and why it makes me want to do it year after year. So this is the fourth time that I am reading through using the chronological format in this sort of way. It's the second year that I've been using the actual Bible recap, and I kind of lost track of how many times I've read through the Bible in its entirety. It's something that I have been doing each year for over a decade. So I think that there is no better way to get to know God, to understand His attributes, and really understand the Bible in the big picture way that helps you piece together all of the events of the Bible, help you really understand the Old Testament and the New Testament and how they relate to each other, plus a ton more. So I have been hearing from other women that have done this, and they love it too. It's really life-changing. It's a wonderful way to get to know God, to really further your relationship with Jesus, and to have a better understanding of the Bible as a whole. And so a lot of women do Bible studies sort of piecemeal. Like you may take a certain topic and then there's a lot of scripture that surrounds that topic that you'll study. Or you'll pick out a particular book of the Bible and you'll really dive in. Now those things are great. But I think what happens lots of times is we don't have a very good understanding then as to how those things will relate to the Bible as a whole. And I know I keep on saying that, but it's really important because the Bible really does have a beginning, middle, and an end. It's God's story, and we're meant to know the whole thing in its entirety. So this is exciting to me. I love sharing it, and I'm gonna kind of dive into what I do each day. So one of the first things is to establish a place in your home somewhere that you can do your Bible study each day. It can be a comfortable corner like I have here in our bedroom where I can just shut the door. It's quiet. It's cozy. I've got a few things set up here to make it even more cozy, like a blanket on the back of my chair. I bring in a cup of tea. I've got all of my materials right here so I don't have to go searching for anything. And this just makes it an enticing place so that I look forward to it even more, and also just very convenient because everything I need is right here, and it's a little time of the day where I can take to myself as well, and so it's a little bit of self-care thrown in there as well. But if you don't have a particular area, and oftentimes I did not, I would put all of my materials in a basket of some sort so that it was very portable. And so then I could take everything with me if I needed to move locations. I still do that sometimes if I want to go outside on a pretty day and do my Bible study there, or if I decide I want to go to the kitchen table or wherever, or if I'm away from home, I'll have everything gathered together and it'll be easy to pack up and take with me. So the most important things that I have gathered in this corner are, of course, my Bible. And the one that I love the most is this Life Essentials Study Bible. You can use any Bible that you like. It doesn't have to be a chronological Bible because it will tell you each day what you were reading, and so you can look that up in any Bible. This just happens to be my favorite. I also keep a little notebook where I can jot down anything that stands out to me from that day's reading. I find that I learn new things every year, and it's really great to make note of those things. I also meet with a group of women each week at my church, and we discuss what we're reading. So this is really great for if I have a question that I want to ask the group, or if I just want to make sure that we hit on these different topics or, you know, different concepts that kind of struck me. I will have notes on that because, believe me, after you've read through at this pace in a week's time, you tend to forget. So I like having the notes. Earlier, I talked about the Bible recap. Now, what that is, as I said earlier, is basically just a reading plan that takes me through the Bible in a year using the chronological format. And so I'm going to have a link down in the description box. You can look for it there. And there's a corresponding podcast that goes with it so that you can do your reading for the day and then listen to the podcast. It is written and read by Tara Lee Cobble, who is amazing, and I highly recommend it. And that's how I did things last year. This year, I'm switching it up just a little bit. They came out with a printed form. It's basically a polished transcript of all of the podcasts, and I'm really enjoying it. I like it for two reasons. First of all, it's just switching things up a little bit since I did the podcast last year. And second of all, I am a visual learner, so I really like seeing it in printed form. I like that I can circle and underline and highlight things as I'm going through. So this has been really fun for me, and I recommend both methods. You can find this plus all of the other resources that I'm showing you in my Amazon store. And I'm just doing that to make it easy for you to find. By all means, if you have a Christian bookstore or some other way that you like to buy your books, do what works for you. Another thing that I love about the Bible recap is you don't have to start on January 1. You can start any time of the year. Just start now, and you're gonna be so glad that you did. Find out from this book, or you can find out from the app, what passages you're reading for the day. Then I read them in my Bible, and as I do that, I take notes in my notebook. And then when I'm finished, I like to either listen to the podcast or read the corresponding passage in this book for that day. And I think that that order is really important because one of the places where we kind of go off the rails sometimes, I think, is always relying on what other people say about the Bible instead of just reading it directly ourselves. So I like to read the passage for the day, really contemplate what God's saying to me through it. Sometimes I'm learning something new about God or how God used a certain person in the Bible or just some type of life application. And if I'm always reading someone else's interpretation of it, I might miss something that God wants to say directly to me. And so I think that that is really important, and that's why I always read my Bible first, and then I go to the podcast or the passage that is corresponding to the reading in the book. When we're reading through the Bible in a year, you are really getting a good idea of the context of what it is that you're reading, because each part builds on the next. Just like a good novel, there's a beginning, a middle, and an end. And it, once you understand that, reading through it chronologically, everything falls into place and makes so much more sense than doing it piecemeal. And so I recommend that you read through the Bible each day for a couple of different reasons. First of all, to get that big picture. And you can also be doing some of these other types of Bible studies in conjunction with it, and it will just give you lots of clarity on both sides. But even more important than that, I think that it's really valuable to be in God's Word each day. So whether that is in a Bible study or reading through chronologically, just grounding yourself in the Word, and if you can do that first thing in the morning, is wonderful. So for me, it really gets my mind in the right place. It helps me eliminate the things that aren't important and really direct my focus upward towards God and outward towards others instead of inward towards myself and my own agenda for the day. So these are the reasons that I find this so important, and the reason why I do it again and again, year after year, every day. I hope that you enjoyed today's video and that you found it helpful. I hope that it encouraged you to set aside a little space in your home, a little time each day to spend in God's Word. I know that you won't regret it. It really is life-changing, and I've talked to loads of women who agree. So let me know in the comments below if you have any questions or concerns about this, and I would love to hear from you about what you are doing each day as you spend time in God's Word. Are you doing this on your own? Are you doing it with a friend? Are you doing it with a group of women like I am? And if you aren't, then I want to encourage you to make steps to start doing that. So thank you so much for spending your time with me here today. Of course, I look forward to hearing from you in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video. Until then, have a wonderful week.